I was hesitant because I don't believe in vaccinations, you know, so I was like, I'm not going to get this. I don't know what it's going to do to me, and I'm already healthy, and I already had COVID, and I was fine. Like, yeah, it kind of felt like the flu, but it wasn't deadly, so I'm like, I don't need this, you know?
We were approached by Jackson County to develop a proposal to address the low vaccination rates on Kansas City's east side, along with addressing some of the other health disparities that we know have been prevalent. And primarily our research has been with the faith-based sector. We've addressed everything from HIV to mental health screening to diabetes prevention, and then most recently COVID-19 testing. We know that for the low vaccination rates that are happening, that we really needed to get into community sectors where people frequent often, where they feel they're in a trusted environment, where they feel like they can go and get accurate information.
Got everybody in the same space looking at health disparities and imagining what we can do to change things. We want to connect folks with life-saving information, life-saving tools, life-saving resources.
We decided to work through four sectors on Kansas City's east side, and those include the faith-based sector, youth organizations, neighborhood associations, and businesses. We found leaders in each of those sectors, and we paired them with someone within UMKC, and these became our sector leads. So we have this huge infrastructure actively talking to their peers, their neighbors, their church members, their customers and clients about getting vaccinated and getting them out to these events.
So I saw these two gentlemen playing basketball and they were super excited. They're like, we don't have those opportunities. Like, let me call my aunt, let me call my uncle, let me tell my family to come out here. When we got up to the event, one of them ended up getting vaccinated.
The focus is for us to raise vaccination rates in this area that is already a vulnerable population to begin with, and maybe also from the perspective of having some vaccine hesitancy. And that in turn opens up opportunities to access to care for chronic illnesses or new illnesses that are being developed because people have other problems besides just COVID right now.
It's systemic, it's historic. There's disparities, main disparity being healthcare access. Folks just don't have access to a provider. And so when you don't have access to your provider, you don't have an opportunity to ask the questions that you need to in order to inform yourself and make an informed decision. What we did was put together teams to go out into the community at these pop-up clinics. And those teams included pharmacists and medical students. And that gave those folks that don't have access to medical care an opportunity to talk with a pharmacist right there, just one-on-one. It gave us an opportunity to motivate them.
So my friend, she thinks it's like a chip getting into you, and it's like, okay, now I don't believe it. But that's her beliefs, and she's not going to get it whatsoever, you know. And I was like, well, hey, I wonder if she's right. This is before I got it, though. But, you know, so different people believe in different things. It's a whole lot of different things they believe in.
Oh, wow. As it relates to misinformation, we've heard the gamut of things.
I don't believe the science.
Mind-controlling devices can make you sterile, make you blind.
Y'all are just trying to kill off the black folks.
Once you hear things like, well, people who are pregnant or want to get pregnant can't get pregnant if they get vaccinated. Once you hear it, you become suspect.
But we know that myths really grow in the vacuum of limited information. And that really means the burden is on us as health professionals to not only provide information, but provide information in a way that makes sense to people.
And that's another thing that the grant has been able to hopefully provide to the community that we're focused on, is that we have the good messaging, the evidence-based messaging that we're bringing to them so that we can build their trust and hopefully make them feel comfortable in order to make that decision to get vaccinated.
Families rely on us. They entrust their children to us to take care of and keep safe and healthy. So this was a natural adjacency for us and for certainly from my perspective to be able to partner with the Our Healthy KC initiative, East Side specifically, and communicate information and factual information to our families.
Since it's doctors and students and or whatever here, they'll be able to better educate them on what to really expect and what's in it. And that is, it's okay, you know, it's safe.
It's been harder to target the youth. A lot of that has to do with the information they see on social media and the fact that they don't feel that they are as much at risk.
I would say a lot of my school is vaccinated, but I still think there's a majority of them that aren't. But we were just like, my dad should definitely take it. Because my dad, you know, he has medical conditions.
It was important for me because my mom works with cancer patients, and also my family has like really bad health issues, and I didn't want to fall up underneath that. So I was like, why not get the vaccine?
Our whole approach has been to meet people where they are, right? Don't push people into something that they don't want to get into, but to give them an opportunity to make an informed decision. And you can't give them that opportunity if you don't provide access. And giving them access to those people that could answer their questions is what we wanted to create. We wanted to create an environment where they were safe, they were comfortable, and if they chose to get vaccinated, then they had the opportunity to do so.
They're really fun. They're very lively. There's lots of people. There's usually some sort of thing for the kids to do, a cookout. It's just a really good time.
When my grandbaby came into this world in July, I said, well, it wasn't all about me. It was more, you know, about keeping them safe.
I did for my family. I did. If it wasn't for them, technically I wouldn't have done it. But I really did it for them. I want to live a long time. I'm trying to live a long time. Hey, I got a grandson I want to see grow up, do this, so.
This older gentleman, he actually belonged to the church. He came up and I asked him, I said, so what made you come out today? You know, I got a new grandbaby. So in order for me to really be with my grandchild, I needed to come out and get vaccinated because they weren't going to keep me away from that baby. When you care enough about your family, you're gonna do whatever it is that you need to do to keep them safe.
They wanna make sure that grandma or grandpa, or aunts and uncles are protected.
I didn't wanna risk bringing COVID home to my wife. She's got a number of health issues. As I'm making visitations, the last thing I wanted to do is bring something home.
So we've met our goal of achieving 5,000 vaccinations on the east side, and we're hoping to far exceed that and actually approach 6,000 vaccinations once we're all done.
I've always wanted to be a part of something bigger than myself, and there's no better grant, no better project than our Healthy KC to be a part of because we're reaching so many different people.
But we can use this same model to address diabetes, to address community violence, to address some of these other endemic type of health conditions that have been a burden to the east side for many, many years.
I feel kind of good that I'm vaccinated, you know, that I can really say that, you know, I'm fully vaccinated now.
I think it's actually nice. It's giving people, I mean, like, yeah, it's free, so it's like they can just come out and get vaccinated. It's like you're helping out your community, you know, trying to get the COVID levels down.
I know I did. I'm fully vaccinated, so I did it for my family. That's all I can say.